pretty much on top of the world. I mean, when you're on a Mount Olympus, you can't get much higher. You're already amongst the gods. And at least you get to taste a little bit of the nectar.
Yeah, we are coming home with numbers on napkins. I'd go to the rot and leave with 20 plus names on a napkin. Babes, all of them.
But they wanted more. The success got the best of them. It was their coach, Dr. Ted Bowling, who pointed the way to future success.
Okay, guys, I know that you did really well this last year, but we got to take this next step up, this next coming year. So, I was thinking the other night, I was watching this Ann Collier special about technology and how to use it to your advantage and so forth. And, I mean, we're talking, apps and iPods and iPhones and how to handle cyberbullying and Wikipedia and, all that kind of stuff. So if you guys want to win this thing next year, and I really think you can, that's the next step.
The lip sync to me is like a story I know, like a puppy who lost its way. The world was changing, and the puppy was getting more technologically savvy. It was like our lip sync team was lost in the woods, and nobody, especially that little boy, society, knew what they wanted in a really great show. Except that puppy was a dog, and the technology, my friend, was a revolution. Nebraska P-Wolves rule.
Why aren't you guys listening?
All right.
Poker face. I like poker face.
Hey, thanks a lot, everybody, for coming tonight. We've got a lot to cover today.
There's so much to cover, guys.
We've got a lot to do.
Do you care about lip sync?
I don't know if you guys just put the
gun on. Do you care about lip sync?
2 days from now.
Whoa! Line game, now.
Alright guys, we're playing the line game. So how many of you guys own that new Snoop Dogg CD? That's what I thought. Alright, well how many of you own an iPad? Don't be shy, it's okay. Now, how many of you have taken part in a Lord of the Rings reenactment? Oh, wow. And how many of you belong to a nonprofit Facebook group? Okay. You can go back now. So how many of you have been a victim of cyberbullying? All right, do you see this? Look to your left and right. You're not strangers from different worlds. You share the same problems. You're a team. You're a team. And if you want to win, you're going to have to stick together. Like friendship bread. Sticky. Yeah. This is how teams work. You find common ground and you build on it. Now who's going to win lip sync?
We are!
Siri, what is the specific heat capacity of water?
Let me check that for you. Mr. Cederberg, what are you doing?
Using technology.
And what you saw right there was just one of the most demonized elements of technology, the cell phone in the classroom. And if you will, you know, educators are caught up in the mix and they just don't know how to handle these smartphones and the development of new content standards based on higher levels of technology and student-based learning, if you will. And what we have here is just a confluence of technology and student-based learning, and it's really, really sad the way a lot of educators are coming down hard on things when, you know, it's going to be what you make of it.
So we didn't know it at the time, but two of our students were caught cheating during the test using text messaging. One was even using that new Siri program.
Due to the new NCAA lip sync legislation, all team members were to be tested, even Tim Stewart. Then the president, Crazy Fred Ojoles, issued the team its death blow.
Can you please comment on Tim Stewart's eligibility?
Those kids came in here, and I said something to the effect of, I'm guessing you already know why I called you in here. Well, they just stood there, you know, pale-faced, looking like a horse with a broken leg that just learned his racing days are over. Tim Stewart, you know, the race in the hole. Well, Tim's past his prime, so his eligibility was up. I couldn't let that slide and still sleep at night. I mean, I love lucid dreaming.
And in the background, there you see Tim Stewart. My God, does he look good. Going back and forth, to and fro, dancing beautifully, like a fawn.
I had contacted Tim Stewart after we realized that we had lost two of our members to cheating. I didn't know that they wouldn't be testing our samples for iron and B vitamins. I had no idea that his eligibility was up, or that the event would be taken this seriously.
On the same day that we lost Tim, that's when the cyberbullying started. Our coach told us to fight fire with fire, and what followed was a vicious smear campaign.
I was only 18. Those girls made me cry.
In all seriousness, cyberbullying is something that cannot be taken lightly. Cyberbullying is defined as the use of information and communication technologies to support deliberate, repeated, and hostile behavior by an individual or group that is intended to harm another. Cyberbullying can be hard to detect since many times the victims do not tell anyone of the bullying. It is important to take action against those who cyberbully and report any instance that one sees.
Yeah, I felt pretty clever. See, I showed him, this is one of my favorite videos, Rudy, I showed it to him, and then, you know, I included one of my favorite speeches. It went something like this. Let me show you. All right, guys, this is it. This is lip sync. I don't know if you've ever been to a pool or not, but there's a bottle of soda in every pool. And I want tonight that bottle of soda to be yours. I want you to work so hard that you go into anaphylactic shock. And the lifeguard comes down and gives you that Coca-Cola because you need sugar. All right, remember, this is lip sync.